Yeah, so welcome everyone to Yoga with Smiles. We started this initiative on International Yoga Day in June, and after 4 months we decided to take it 5 days a week, Monday to Friday. So Brindavan Yoga and Smile Makers Training has pleasure in bringing this workshop to you. We will be doing yoga every day, and today we have a new intern, Marina. Am I pronouncing your name right? Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you, Marina. And I will start by giving you 5 to 10 minutes of smile tips. So today is a very important day for me because it is my father's 88th birthday. If he was here, he would have been celebrating 88 years. And I always want to remember him with a smile. And I remember... Yeah, he's not physically here, but yes, he's always there with me. My role model, my everything, my hero. So, you know, I remember I asked him on his 82nd birthday, I had asked him, you know, they're supposed to see 1,000 moons, we had done a big puja and all. And I said, what do you have any advice for us? And you know what he told me? He says, I am 82 years old. And I don't have one single regret in my life. And I thought that was so wonderful. You know, how can you live your life? And, you know, I'm not saying he's a perfect person. Nobody is perfect. Everybody has their pluses and minuses. Everybody talks about everyone behind their back or in front of their back. But the fact is, if you can say that, I think your life is really, you know, worth it. He died at 85, but I will never forget, you know, his philosophy of life. He always, you know, lived his life on his terms. And the tip that I'm going to you to give it today is about your birthdays or anniversaries or any kind of milestones which you remember, any important day that is there in your life. I know we celebrate it, we go to a restaurant, call friends, eat food, whatever it is. But I would like you to use your milestone days to, again, spend some time with yourself. Because the biggest adventure in this world you're going to have is with yourself. And I want to introduce the concept of SWOT. Anybody knows what is it? S-W-O-T. Anybody knows what is SWOT? No? Okay. So the full form of SWOT is S stands for strengths, W stands for weaknesses, O stands for opportunities, and T stands for threats. So, you know, when you go to a garage, your car is running from one point to another, and your car has to go still many more kilometers. But you go to a garage, you stop and you service your car, isn't it? Even though it's in running condition, you still give your car for service after 15,000 miles or 10,000 kilometers. So your birthday or your milestone day will be like a day where you give yourself, you go to your own garage, go to Shobha garage or go to, you know, Bhagya garage or whatever it is. And you spend some time with yourself and write down what you look at the condition of your car. Okay, so write down what do you think are your strengths, all the good qualities that you think you have. We are very conjuice. We generally do not see the good things about ourselves. So about yourself, your circumstances, whatever, everything is about your, write down your strengths. That is S. Then another place that you write is where do you think you need to improve? Okay? I will call it areas of improvement. So certain qualities of yours which you think that you do not have it and you want to have it, or you think that you want to stop certain qualities, okay? That comes under W. I don't like to call it weaknesses. I call it areas of improvement. So again, make a list, because this is like you're servicing yourself. Make a list of all the areas of improvement. And this is a fantastic exercise which I give people to do often in front of me. Now, I want to give you one example of a true story. There is a man, he went to a radio station for an audition. They told him, your voice is too bass. We don't like you. And he was rejected. He went for a film audition and they told him, you're too tall. And we don't like, because you're too tall for a normal hero, Indian Hindi film hero. So tell me something. Anybody knows who I'm talking about? True story. Huh? I'm talking. Who? Any idea?
Amitabh Bachchan.
Very good.
Amitabh
Bachchan. Yeah, who said that? Who said that? Too many people, so I don't know any of. So thank you for that. Yes, it's a true story of Amitabh Bachchan. So imagine Amitabh Bachchan came home and he wrote, you know, my height is my weakness, or my bass voice is my weakness. He would not be Amitabh Bachchan today. That is why I am saying, when you write your areas of improvement, by itself there is nothing. What people considered as his weakness actually became his strength. His height became his strength. It was part of his personality. His voice became his strength because he had such a lovely bass voice. So that what people considered as his weakness became his strength. So when you write, when you do this exercise, please understand, nothing is true. Okay? Something which can seem like a strength in one situation may actually be a weakness in another situation. Something that may look as a weakness in one perspective may actually be a strength in another perspective. So along with strength and weakness, you also need to write opportunities and threats. So any quality which you can use in your situation to your advantage becomes a strength. So you need to write a strength in relation to the opportunity. And any quality which you need to improve and you have not improved and the situation around you is changing, okay, that becomes a threat. Now I'll give you one example of my strength. Okay, for example, I can write my strength. I like my communication skills. Okay, I love to express myself. So probably I'll put that as my strength. Now one of the areas of improvement which I really need to work on is technology. So the world is changing, and if I do not improve my technology skills, that's a huge big threat. Do you get that? Because we are now living in a world of technology. So when I write in the world of technology, my sitting and bothering about communication will not help unless I also improve my technical skills. Do you get that? So just spend some time, especially on your birthday, take your time, any milestone day, okay? And I do this exercise quite regularly, maybe once a year, or on a wedding anniversary day, something, you know, any important day of your life, sit and write your SWOT. It is called SWOT analysis. It's like your car, only when you check whether the petrol is less, then you will put more petrol. Only when you check that the air is less, then you will put more air. But unless you know the air is less, you will keep on going in the tire and one day the tire will burst. Do you get it? So this SWOT exercise is very, very important for you all to do it in your, probably your milestone days. Do you get that? So thank you for listening to this concept of SWOT. And as you do it, you will really smile and you will create more smiles around you. So thank you very much, and over to you now for the yoga.